Welcome to the .NET MAUI Rotator Control tutorial. The Syncfusion.NET MAUI Rotator Control enables interactive image rotation and navigation with swiping, autoplay, and tapping features. In this video, I will show you how to add the .NET MAUI Rotator Control to a .NET MAUI application. I will demonstrate how to populate the rotator items, restrict swiping, hide the dots navigation strip, and customize the navigation strip mode and position. Additionally, I'll show how to customize thumbnails, display the header text, enable autoplay, adjust the navigation delay duration, stop the looping, and show navigation buttons. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, incorporate the rotator control into the .NET MAUI application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Rotator NuGet package, so I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Rotator package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the apps.xaml CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI rotator namespace. I initialize the rotator control within a frame and set the frame width to 350 and height to 500. You can populate the rotator using the rotator item or item template. In this example, I will use the rotator item to display the image. The rotator item class has three fields: item content, image, and item text. To assign values to the image field, first create a folder called view model and a class named dataViewModel. Make this class public and define the property called rotatorItems of type rotatorItem class. Add a constructor for the class. Inside this constructor, add the data object with a field image name to the rotatorItems property. These images are already stored in the resource folder. Once it is done, let me navigate to the main page XAML file to bind the data of the rotator. Here, I will import the namespace of the dataViewModel and add binding context to the content page. Access the dataViewModel class here using the local XAML namespace. Lastly, assign the rotatorItems property to the itemSource property. Look, the first image is displayed. You can swipe to see the next image. You can also select the image by tapping the navigation strip at the bottom. To restrict swiping, set the Enable Swiping property to False. Now, swiping is disabled. If you tap the dots, images will change. Next, to hide the dots navigation, set the dot placement to None. There are three built-in options: Default, None, and Outside. By default, it is set to the default mode. Note that the dot placement is only for the dots navigation. Before running the application, remove the Enable Swiping property. Check here. Dots navigation is hidden. Now I will show you how to customize the navigation strip. The Rotator control provides two built-in navigation strip mode options, Dots and Thumbnail. By default, it is set to Dots. To customize it, set the navigation strip mode to Thumbnail. Before running the application, remove the dot placement property. Now you can see thumbnails at the bottom of the Rotator. To position the navigation strip at the top, set the navigation strip position property to Top. The four built-in positions are Top, Bottom, Left, and Right. By default, it's set to Bottom. See, the thumbnails are displayed at the top. To customize thumbnail's appearance, set the selected thumbnail stroke to dark green and unselected thumbnail stroke to light pink. Looking here, the thumbnail's appearance has changed. Next, I will show you how to display headers for the Rotator items. I navigate to the View Model class and set the item text to Bird1 for the first Rotator item instance, and set the item text for other instances in the same way. Then, navigate to the main page XAML and set the isTextVisible property to True to display the text in the Rotator items. Note that the isTextVisible property works only if the collection is of type Rotator item. Before running the application, remove the code for customizing the appearance of thumbnails. As you can see here, the text is now visible. To select the third item programmatically, set the selected index property to 2. Look, the third item is selected. Next, to navigate to the next item automatically, set the Enable Autoplay property to True. Once the application runs, you can see it automatically navigate to the next item. If you want to decrease the time delay while switching to the next item, set the navigation delay property to 500 milliseconds. By default, it's set to 1000 milliseconds. Now, the delay time is decreased. In the previous output, you saw the Rotator items looping repeatedly. To restrict the looping once it reaches the last item, set the Enable Looping property to False. Now, when it reaches the last item, autoplay is stopped. Finally, I will demonstrate how to display navigation buttons for thumbnails. Set the Show Navigation Button property to True and the Enable Autoplay to False to stop autoplay. Looking here, the navigation buttons are displayed, allowing you to easily preview the items. In this video, you learned how to add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI Rotator control to the .NET MAUI application. I demonstrated how to populate the Rotator items, restrict swiping, hide the dots navigation strip, and customize the navigation strip mode and position. Additionally, I showed how to customize thumbnails, display the header text, enable autoplay, adjust the navigation delay duration, stop looping, and show navigation buttons. To learn more about Rotator control features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.